Hi there, welcome to day two of the Keto and Alkaline Diet 5-Day Challenge. I'm really excited you're here. I'm Laura Rimmer. If you don't know me, I'm a nutritionist, a natural health coach, author of the book The Alkaline 5 Diet, published on Hay House, and really a keto and alkaline diet specialist. I've been in this area of work for almost two decades now, 20 years, and I'm here to guide you through these 5 days and these videos. So welcome to day two. Thank you so much if you participated by commenting yesterday in our day one training. And if you haven't done that training yet for some reason, then whilst these daily trainings are standalone trainings, I do really recommend that you go back and do any previous days that you might have missed, because you will get the most out of it, you will get the most value, and it will, you know, it will benefit you. So do go and complete day one's training if you haven't done it. If you have, fantastic. Let's move on to day two. So today, we're going to look at what the benefits of the keto diet is. So firstly, what is the keto diet? What is ketosis? What is the ketogenic diet? Just so we're absolutely clear and we're on the same page. And then what are the major benefits? Okay, so let's just dive straight in. What is the keto diet exactly? Well, it's a diet that's very high in fat, it's moderate in protein, and it's low in carbohydrates. And the most important things there are high fat, low carb. So you might have heard diets called a low carb, high fat diet as well. So a keto diet is a really kind of the end of the spectrum of a low carb, high fat diet. So the ratio of calories are 80-15-5, roughly, give or take a few percentages here or there. So 80% of your calories each day should come from fat, which sounds really high, I know, and we'll get into that. 15% from protein. So as you can see, it's moderate. It's not the Atkins diet, it's not a high protein diet, it's a moderate to low protein diet. And 5% of your calories, just 5% of your calories from carbohydrates. So why do we want to do this? Well, when we restrict carbohydrates, then our body switches up fuel source from burning glucose and glycogen from carbohydrates, which most of us are used to doing most of the time. Okay, so that's our body's standard fuel source, especially in the day and age we live in now and in our Western society, where we're eating carbohydrate-rich foods all of the time, breads, pastas, fruits, vegetables, sugar, refined carbohydrates, pastries, white flour, all that kind of stuff, okay? And we're switching up that fuel source into fats in the form of ketones, okay? And I'll get into what ketones are in a second. So why do we want to do this? Well, the biggest thing that you need to know about the ketogenic diet and switching fuel source from carbs to fats in the form of ketones is that we regulate our blood sugar. We're not spiking our blood sugar, we're making it stable, because fat is the only macronutrient out of carbs, proteins, and fats. Fat is the only one which doesn't produce a significant insulin response. So it doesn't spike your blood sugar, and therefore it doesn't spike an insulin response to manage and lower that blood sugar. So insulin is your most important hormone in your body. It has such a big function. It has such a big effect on the other functionalities within your body, that the massive thing that the ketogenic diet does is that it regulates that hormone insulin. So you haven't got these peaks and troughs, ups and downs. So it regulates your energy, your mental stability, your blood sugar, okay? So let's just cover what the keto diet is not. So ketosis, nutritional ketosis, is not ketoacidosis. That's something that type 1 diabetics have when their blood sugar is really not in a good state. So that's a dysfunction. Basically, ketoacidosis is a dysfunction. Nutritional ketosis is a very healthy function, okay? Keto is not a fad diet. It's been around for a century in clinical practice, so it's not unscientific or unproven. It is almost, like I say, a century of credible health studies and great results. Started off as a clinical protocol for the management of epilepsy, still used very much now with epileptics to address and control seizures. So that's how it started out. It's kind of life. And experimentation in clinical practice, at least anyway. And since then, it's been used to address many, many other diseases, disorders, illnesses, and to produce a very healthy way of living, again, as we'll get into. So by this rationale, the keto diet is not unhealthy, even though there's a lot of media propaganda that will try and tell you it is. It's actually a very, very healthy diet, okay? And I say this as someone who has been through all the diets under the sun. I was myself a vegan, so completely plant-based, high-carb, low-fat for over 6 years. So I was the complete opposite. I was high-carbohydrate, low-fat. Now I am high-fat, low-carbohydrate, and this is the better diet. And it took me almost a decade and a half of research to get to this point where I moved through all the dietary misinformation, picked out what works, have discarded what doesn't work, and discarded the propaganda, because there is a lot of propaganda in media and medical science and research and things. I worked for a few years as medical research manager here in the UK, so you know, I have got a background in this. I've got a lot of experience with standard medicine and the standard nutritional model, and also this this model, which is actually this works, the keto diet works, okay? So what are ketones? Well, there's three ketone types, and you don't need to remember these, but they're kind of useful to know. So the first one is acetoacetate, second is beta hydroxybutyrate, and the third is acetone. And these three ketone bodies are produced by breaking down fatty acids from fats in your liver, okay? So therefore, in order to get your body into kickstarting the process of ketosis, we need to, first of all, restrict our carbs, because in the presence of carbohydrates, you're not going to be producing ketones. But you need to eat much more fat. Now, we can use two different sources of fat. Dietary fat, so hence we need to up our fats in our daily calories. But also, here's the thing, bodily fat. We all have at our disposal tens of thousands of calories available to burn through the fat that's on our body. And even the leanest of us have around about 40,000 calories of fat. So that's pounds and pounds and pounds of fat. That's hours and hours and hours and hours and days of exercise and energy at our disposal within our own bodies that can be utilized, converted into ketones and burnt as a fuel source, okay? So you might be already thinking, okay, does this have weight loss benefits? Yes, it does. We'll get onto that. So what kind of fats are healthy fats then? I'm going to give you a high level overview here of the different fat types and their role that they should be playing in your diet. So we have monounsaturated fats, which I'm sure you've heard of all these, but so what are monounsaturated fats? Things like avocados. Avocados are an amazing, amazing superfood that you need to include every day in your diet. I have an avocado every day, and there's many different ways you can have avocados. I've produced lots of recipes, tasty puddings and desserts, as well as in salads and things like that that you can do with avocados. So if you're thinking, I don't like the consistency of avocados, you have lots of different options, smoothies and yeah. Olive oil is another great monounsaturated fat. So polyunsaturated fats, so things like your omega 3, 6s and 9s, you want to be focusing on more omega 3s than 6s and 9s. So things like oily fish, so wild caught salmon, and things like cod liver oil as well. So that's your polyunsaturated fats. Also things like nuts and seeds in moderation. You also then have your saturated fats. And these are the things that many people are afraid of. And I myself was very nervous of the thought of saturated fats for years, especially animal-based saturated fats. So again, as a vegan, as I was, I completely avoided any animal saturated fats for several years, 6 years. And then I was vegetarian before that for another couple of years. Now I'm the complete opposite. I understand the science behind it. So why this switch? Why am I recommending saturated fats? Because quite simply, they are very healthy. I'll say it again, saturated fats are very healthy. These aren't the fats that are going to clog your arteries. Those are trans fats and industrial seed oils that are bad for you. It's those things like margarines, cottonseed oil, canola oil, soybean oil. Those are the fats that are corrosive to your arteries and that produce things like cancer, heart disease. Saturated fats are not. Saturated fats raise your good cholesterol, lower the bad cholesterol. They protect your heart and arteries. They protect your brain health. They provide much needed nutrients. I could talk for a whole hour on the benefits of saturated fats, but I will say at this point, if you want to find out more about this, I would point you to the work of Sally Fallon Morell, with a presentation on YouTube called The Oiling of America. So go and check that out if you want to know more about this. This is a high level overview, so I'm not going to go into a lot more detail, but suffice to say, saturated animal fats are very good for you. And also plant-based saturated fats, things like coconut oil, a wonderful, wonderful superfood, again, that I include in my diet virtually every day. So isn't too much saturated fat bad for you? No. No, the science does not support that claim at all. The science says the opposite. So why are we told in our nutritional guidelines to reduce saturated fat? Quite simply, because of the work of Ansel Keys in the 1950s, with propaganda when the vegetable oil industry started rising in prominence and had a lot of money behind it to promote its agenda and the sale of industrial seed oils and margarines because of longer shelf life and high profitability. There was a big media and science kind of push to promote vegetable oils and kind of castigate, that's a big word, I don't need to use such big words, malign or, you know, discredit, whatever you want to say, blacken the name of saturated fats. But the fact is, we have been eating saturated animal fats, saturated fats for millennia, for thousands of years. And our ancestors, you know, thousands of years ago, were not having problems. They weren't dying of cancer from saturated fats. It's only since we've bought in trans fats and industrial seed oils, they are the problem, okay? So I hope that you're getting that distinction. The enemy here is not saturated fats. They're good for you. Trans fats, industrial seed oils, these highly processed vegetable oils are the ones you need to be avoiding, okay? So let's move on. Don't believe the government unscientific hype. Now, I had a big fear of fat because of this propaganda. I had a fear of fat for years. When I was plant-based vegan, I was very, very low fat. And for a little while, you know, there is a massive rise in the vegan diet being pushed, and it's going to increase over the next few years. Don't get caught up in that hype, because you might experience, if you're someone who doesn't eat particularly healthily, if you have, you know, if you're used to having a lot of processed food, junk food and things, if you go plant-based vegan and high carb, low fat, you will experience an upturn in your health for a little while. But the key is, it is only for a little while. If you do it for any length of time, so for me, after 5-6 years, I started feeling listless, more tired. I was craving sugar all of the time. I was craving fat, and I just knew my health wasn't as high as it had been in the past and as good as it could be. So I was, at the end of that period, I'd run a lot of marathons and I was training hard for athletic and endurance events, and I started to see a decline in my health. That's when I really had to question do I need to bring back in animal-based products? And my research led me to the keto diet. So let me short circuit any mistakes, years of going down the wrong path that you might make, and tell you that you need, you know, saturated fats and a high carb, low fat diet is not the way to go. So when I first knew this, I got on board with a keto diet. When I first started increasing the fat in my diet, I had a real fear of it. Now, I don't know about you, but as a woman especially, I felt that if I eat lots of fat, if I go out to restaurants with friends and I have real full fat butter and lots of it, people are gonna judge me. People are gonna think, she's gonna put on weight. Isn't that indulgent? Isn't that gluttonous? So I had this fear, and I remember walking around a supermarket and I picked up a big block of butter and some coconut oil and some full fat organic red meat with all the fat on it. So a rump steak, and I was looking for the fattiest cut there. And I had this guilt. I felt that, I don't know, this was years of conditioning, and maybe you can relate to that. If you think, you know, I could never sit down and eat a big, you know, cut of meat with all the fat on, then you have the same fear that I had. And I tell you what, it took me a little while to get over, but after a few weeks of just eating fats and realizing I wasn't becoming the size of a house, I actually lost weight and I started feeling much better, having much more energy and felt really good. Then you will overcome that fear of fat too. And enjoying, you know, real butter, grass-fed butter with vegetables. You know, I was used to eating a lot of vegetables as a vegan, but all of a sudden when I was able to have 3 or 4 tablespoons of butter with it, not a small little amount, but a nice amount of butter with some black pepper and a few spices, all of a sudden things like cabbage and broccoli and cauliflower became amazingly delicious foods in the presence of things like butter and olive oil and coconut oil. So I want to encourage you, think about it. Do you have a fear of fat? And if you do, let my story be an encouragement to you, and do not fear fat. Get over that fear, okay? The advantage of using ketones as fuel, let's talk about that. So regarding your metabolism, ketones are able to create much higher amounts of energy per molecule than glucose. Okay, so the studies show that to your brain especially, your brain has up to 32 times more oxygen available to it when your body is burning ketones rather than glucose. Now think about that. When you get into ketosis, you will have, and you do have, much more stable and sustainable energy source, a more sustainable energy source, and that produces less hunger. So cravings diminish, your hunger diminishes, but also this extra oxygen to your brain, what can that do? Well, I know in my own experience, and many people who I work with, many of my clients have experienced this huge surge in mental energy, mental clarity, and focus. And isn't that something we all struggle with in this day and age? Feeling distracted, unfocused, undisciplined. That is going to change for you once you get into nutritional ketosis. So let's talk about some of the major benefits of the keto diet then, of getting into ketosis. Well, reduced inflammation in your body, reduced food cravings and decreased hunger, better fat burning. So fat burning will be faster, easier for you, easier weight loss, because you're also using your body's fat source and converting that to ketones too. Mental clarity and focus, clear skin, autophagy. Now this is just a big word that means cell repair and cell renewal. So that is anti-aging, okay? I myself know that I feel and look younger now. I'm almost 40 years old and I feel great, and my skin is clearer now than it has been in the last probably decade. Plus, other major benefits, reduced risk of the major diseases. So diabetes, because there is no big spikes in blood sugar and insulin, you have what's called metabolic flexibility. Cancer cells can only thrive, can only be fueled by sugar, interestingly enough. So when you get into ketosis, it basically kills off the cancer cells, it starves the cancer cells, whereas your body's healthy cells have this metabolic flexibility. They can burn either glucose or fats and ketones, okay? And I would point you to the work of Dr. Thomas Seyfried for a lot more on this, keto and cancer. Alzheimer's disease, This is the diet to address Alzheimer's disease for prevention and reversal. Heart disease, as I've talked about, saturated fats, nutritional ketosis promotes heart health and good healthy arteries and right cholesterol levels, whereas vegetable oils and margarines don't. Leaky gut. So if you have any problems with indigestion, Crohn's, colitis, IBS, anything like that, anything, autoimmune diseases, allergies, skin diseases, that kind of stuff, that usually stems from a problem in the gut, a microbiome dysfunction, gut dysbiosis, and that is really eased and addressed with a ketogenic diet. So many other autoimmune diseases and much more. So, day two actions. What are the actions for today then? Write down how you are going to include more healthy fats into your diet. You might need to go back, rewind this video, go back and look at the list of healthy fats. Think of some foods that you want to include, that you enjoy, that you want to increase in your diet. Is it going to be grass-fed butter with, say, vegetables? Is it going to be switching up margarine for butter? Is it going to be having more olive oil with salads? Is it going to be including an avocado a day? So let me know. Write those things down. Write down how you plan to reduce your carbohydrates, because I can guarantee that if you're not following a ketogenic diet currently, you're having too many carbs, and that will take its toll if it hasn't already on your life. So I want you to be thinking about reducing those carbohydrates, especially things like white refined sugar, white refined carbs, corn, all those processed things, but also, you know, some of the more healthy things like healthy whole grains, they can cause gut problems, certainly glutinous foods. So what carbohydrates are you going to reduce in your diet? And when you've written those things down, share them in our Facebook group. This is an interactive group. So share and let other people, you know, encourage you and encourage other people. And feel free to email me and post below in the comments here as well. So that's your day two actions. So go and do that. Tomorrow's training, we're looking at the power of alkaline foods coupled with ketosis, okay? So how alkaline and keto together is a double punch, powerful health combo. So that's what we're going to be looking at. Go and do today's assignment. I'll see you in the comments and in tomorrow's training. Bye for now.